Welcome to the World Rally Championship from Germany. The notorious Rally Deutschland is a tarmac rally like no other. The lay of the land here, combined with the effect of the unpredictable weather on grip levels, result in an action-packed event. Day one was a Deutschland classic, setting up a fascinating day two. The tank training Panzerplatte is our stage of the day. The surface is broken concrete, and the horrendous Hinkelsteins lurk stage side, miss the right line, and miss the rest of the rally. We'll follow our featured driver Chris Meek as he looks to improve on his fifth place. And also in today's show, watch Loeb and Ogier battle for the lead, plus all the key action from a dramatic day two. The action starts in the fast and flowing Saarland forests before the ultimate test of the Panzerplatte on the Baumholder military range, where the rugged concrete places a huge onus on tyre durability. Ford knew that if they wanted to defeat the eight-time Deutschland winner Sebastian Loeb, they would have to strike early. They would need an aggressive strategy to unsettle the imperious world champion. Jari Matti Latvala struck that early blow, winning the first stage. Ford's first stage win in Germany for 3 years. How would Loeb react? The day and potentially the rally was decided by three of Citroën's finest competitors, Sebastian Loeb, Sebastian Ogier and Guy Botzlender, their head weatherman. Citroën predicted rain, selected soft compound tyres for better grip in the second stage and destroyed the Fords, who'd opted for hard compound tyres best suited to the dry. As the heavens opened, Hirvonen and Latvala dropped over 30 seconds. Things then went from bad to worse for Ford's Finns as Latvala had a puncture, then engine failure in the afternoon. Hirvonen damaged his suspension and ended over a minute behind. It had been a Citroën masterstroke, and it's on such moments the titles are won. Rally Deutschland also claimed her customary victims along the way. Loeb leads his teammate by 7.4 seconds. Having matched him on gravel, Ogier is now desperate to prove he can do the same on tarmac. But will the team allow him to attack Loeb's lead? Our featured driver Chris Meek will be delighted with his first day, but he knows his job is far from complete.
Day two's a challenge, you know. We have the normal Saarland region stages through the countryside, and then you have the one big stage of Panzerplatte, which is it's as fearsome as it always was. You know, there's 36 k's in there. It doesn't matter whether it's 46 or 36, it goes on forever, and junction after junction, and you have to try and manage your tires. And you know, top of your priority list will not be to hit a Hinkelstein, that's for sure.
First into the second day stages will be the rally leader Loeb. Can his teammate Ogier mount a challenge today? A long way adrift in third is Mikko Hirvonen. He starts ahead of the mini drivers Sordo and Meek after their terrific opening day. Petter Solberg had a difficult first leg. He's into action just ahead of his brother Henning and former F1 champion Kimi Raikkonen. Jari Matti Latvala once again has to fight back from early problems. Mats Osberg and Dutchman Dennis Kuipers round off the leading WRC starters. Further back, Matt Wilson and Ken Block will hope to improve from disappointing starts. First up on this crucial second day are the 11 kilometres of the Hermeskel stage, a fast and flowing road through farmland, not a cloud in sight, so no game-changing tyre choices to make this morning. And leading from the front, as he so often does, is world champion Sebastian Loeb. The undisputed master of these stages is always incredible to watch, and you can see how much more flowing these roads are compared with the junction-filled stages of day one. Loeb completely in control as ever, but with his teammate less than 7.5 seconds back, he needs to maintain this breathtaking pace. With the second Citroën of Sebastian Ogier more than a minute clear of the rest of the field, the French team are in a really strong position. It will be interesting to see how long they allow their drivers to continue fighting. Ogier just 0.3 seconds down on Loeb in that stage, again proving he can match his teammate on tarmac.
Sebastian ended the first one on Saturday morning. How was that?
Oh, it's okay. It's a bit dusty at the end.
You don't look very happy.
I have no comment.
Well, Ogier is not happy. Perhaps team orders have already been called. There's certainly friction in the Citroën squad. Mini, meanwhile, have had a really promising first tarmac outing so far. Danny Sordo is one of a very limited number of drivers who's challenged Loeb on asphalt in recent years. He starts day two in fourth. If the team can squeeze a bit more power from their BMW engines, the future looks very bright indeed. Starting the second day, just 17 seconds off the pace of his tarmac specialist teammate, Alpha driver Chris Meek has also made a really impressive start. Bit of a moment there for Meek. There's a sign of how hard the British star is pushing.
Yeah, to try and get speed at this level, you can't make any mistakes. It's about perfection, and yeah, I wasn't perfect in there.
Well, Meek frustrated with himself, and well, he might be, starting the day just 2.2 seconds behind the Mini driver, his 2003 world champion Petter Solberg. For a man accustomed to fighting for podium places, the Norwegian would not have enjoyed lying in sixth place overnight. Petter takes advantage of Meek's mistake and moves up to fifth. Dennis Kuipers is enjoying Rally Deutschland. It's as close as the Dutchman can get to a home event. Firm Power Tools World Rally Team driver certainly looks at home. He jumps up two places to seventh in Hermeskel. Matt Wilson struggled to find his confidence on the opening day and has started the morning down in 12th position.
Square right, slippy maybe. 220.
Oh, he's lost control and off the road. Big impact with that small tree. Brush with disaster there for the Brit, but he seems to have got away with that. Wilson gets back on the stage without loss of position. Into the 14-kilometre Bösenberg stage, and let's get back to that intriguing fight at the front. Loeb had the upper hand in the opening stage, remember, but it remains to be seen if there has been team orders given with this strong 1-2 finish at stake.
Yeah, maybe you have to ask him. But I think that's the best thing to do in our situation. We are far in front of everybody, so we'll see what he's doing now.
Interesting comments from Loeb, not going as far as admitting team orders, but he does acknowledge they would be crazy to throw away such a strong position. Ogier was beaten in stage 7. Let's see how he gets on in Bösenberg. It's looking good. Well, if there has been team orders, I'm not sure how Citroën will feel about that back at base. Again, I don't think we're going to get a word from Ogier. Something clearly going on at Citroën this morning. Henning Solberg has had a tough day so far, suffering a strange vibration in the car. He's already slipped to eighth. Whoa, and the Norwegian just bouncing off the line and off the road there. Quick trip across the field, and Henning soon back on his way.
Crest 60, short.
Well, the gap between the two Frenchmen leading the way is down to 3.8 seconds after stage 7. But look at that gap back to third place, Heerven, and that's why Citroën are keen to maintain those positions. Danny Sordo remains the leading Mini in fourth. After losing almost 4 seconds to Ogier in stage 8, Loeb will look to stamp his authority back on the rally here in Birkenfelder. Seb's incredible car control on display again, and he's sent another reminder to his young compatriot about who's in charge. Loeb is quicker this time. He pulls another 3.2 seconds away. Loeb's former teammate, Danny Sordo, meanwhile, is still in impressive form. In just the third competitive outing for the Mini Works team and the car's first event on tarmac, his times are very close to Mikko Hirvonen's. The Ford man still tantalizingly close in the final podium place. Our featured driver Chris Meek may have lost the position to Petter Solberg this morning, but he's certainly not conceded defeat. Chris beat the Norwegian in the previous stage and looks really determined again here in stage 9. It's the first time the Northern Irishman has consistently run this high up the WRC standings, but he looks like he's been doing this for years. Another strong time from Meek then, but how will Petter Solberg react? The Norwegian's co-driver Chris Patterson, actually a former navigator for Meek. But they've had a subdued rally so far and it isn't getting any better. Petter's punctured a tyre. He's really having to manhandle the DS3 through the last few kilometres. More than half a minute is lost and Petter slips back behind Meek on the leaderboard. The season is becoming increasingly frustrating for the former world champion. Meek moving back up to fifth was the only position change in the top 10 in stage 9. At the front, Loeb continues to keep his teammate Ogier at arm's length for now, with Hirvonen still a distant third place. Germany again causing problems for some of the WRC's finest, while rally leader Loeb makes his final preparations before the epic Panzerplatte. Our stage of the day is next. Welcome back to the German countryside, where Rally Deutschland is about to bare its teeth. The Hinkelsteins are waiting. Next is the big one. Arena Panzerplatte has become this event's iconic stretch of road. This is our stage of the day. For 34 kilometres, the abrasive concrete road snakes its way across the Bomholder military range, with the huge Hinkelstein rocks lying stateside. They're designed to keep tanks on the road. If you hit them in a rally car, they hurt. One man who knows these roads better than most is eight-time Germany winner Sebastian Loeb. We're away, Loeb charging up through the gears, 0 to 100 kilometres an hour in around 3.5 seconds in the Tarmac Spec Citroën DS3. Sebastian is first to tackle this monster of a stage. You can see the Hinkelsteins lying menacingly alongside the road. And what is this man going to do in Panzerplatte? It's been an interesting morning so far for Sebastian Ogier. It remains to be seen what has been going on behind the scenes at Citroën. But out in the stages, we've seen an angry, aggressive drive from Ogier on day two. Mikko Hirvonen has again been unable to match the times of the Citroën total drivers over the first three stages this morning. For the next 34 kilometres, Mikko will need to be completely focused on the pace notes from Jarmo Leitinen. Stage of the day is also famous for the Gina jump. Sordo is about to hit it now. We saw the minis look tidy over the jumps in Finland a few weeks ago. And again in Germany, this John Cooper works really does fly through the air well. Perfect landing on four wheels. Now we know Ken Block likes to fly. We've seen that from the recent release of his new Gymkhana 4 video.
Jump 100, danger. Leftover crest into
the wow, the American with an absolutely enormous leap over the Gina jump. That was huge. Brave stuff from both drivers, but very different techniques over the jump. We can compare them now using the WRC stage simulator. Approaching the crest, Block was surprisingly 7 kilometres an hour slower at the takeoff point. And let's look at that total distance jump. The Monster World Rally Team driver clearing 41 metres compared to Sordo's 29, but it does go to show the biggest air is not necessarily quickest. Sordo pulling away on the landing. Well, let's get back up to the sharp end now, and the rally leader is not far from the finish of Panzerplatte. Oh, he's overcooked it into that left-hander. Loeb forced into evasive action there as he hit a slippery patch of gravel. Unforgiving Hinkelsteins lying around there too. Seb quickly back on his way, but with such a small gap to his teammates, every second counts. Ogier had been a second or two down on Loeb through every split time before that rare mistake from his compatriot. Well, let's see if he does take advantage. Yes, despite those team orders, the momentum swings back in Ogier's direction. 2.3 seconds made up there.
Your frustration earlier on in the day, have you been told the two cars have to hold position?
I have nothing to say about that. I just try to improve my speed here. I think we are in the right direction.